Lord will fight for us.
Morena o ta re lwanela.
What we need to do is to keep silent and remain calm. The Lord is having a plan that people will glorify God by seeing us defeating our enemies. We Christians do not fight by our response. I'm here to tell you that keep silent and you will see victory and the Lord will fight for you. If you want to know that God wants to fight for you will see everything happen against you. Remain calm and keep silent. That's how we overcome. The Egyptians, they come to make us slaves. In other words, they come to make us to live a life that we're not supposed to live. A life of lack. A life where we find that we are in desolation. So this is the time where you find that your identity have to be taken away from you. That when Egyptians fight you, they are removing your identity. They take your possession. They remove you where you belong. But if you are Christian, when they are approaching, don't show them any sign that you can fight them, because the battle belongs to God. I said the battle belongs to God. Don't take that battle to yourself. The Lord will fight by what I'm telling you. I'm beginning to undermine your problem. The Lord our God will never leave us, and he's not just there. It's not that there to communicate. It's not just there to stand with us. When we face the enemies, he's there also to fight for us. Our God can fight. He's about to fight. The things that I have learned from the scriptures, and I found the reason why God fight for us, because he will supply what he's having to us. The reason why he fight for us, he have got good plans for us.
Our
God is jealousy of us. He can fight for us. Sometimes you must leave things to happen as they are, and you just say, Lord, you will fight. You people, you were not aware that the Lord can fight. If you want to know God can fight, fight a Christian. Just fight a Christian. You will see God will fight. Rejection from the people you trust doesn't mean that God cannot fight for you. Can I say this to you? There's an expected end. The Lord wants to bring it to you. Don't be hopeless. Don't worry about what you are facing. Listen, the Lord wants to fight for you and bring what you thought it will never come to you. When the Lord fights, no prayer can change the situation. The Lord wants to fight for you to extend that. There will be no battle that your children will experience again. Manipulation from Satan can be more if you don't feed your enemy. When you feed your enemy, your enemy become a channel of information. When you feed your enemy, you have exposed Satan. The Spirit says, do not be afraid of all of them, because the battle is not yours. The battle is mine. Sometimes we need to look at this. When we see all these things that are happening, let us look unto him. Because he is the one who fights for us. The battle belongs to God. Do not look around and be afraid. From today, don't take any battle to yourself. It's how the Lord fights for you. He presents himself and show that he's the one who's reigning. Those who are fighting you, they will see the hand of the living God upon your life. He's about to fight for you in your business. He's about to fight for you in your job. He's about to fight for you whatever you are doing. Don't look back. Carry on. He's fighting for you.